Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with chapter 6 of Microwave Engineering. In this chapter, we are dealing with the family of microwave solid state devices, especially for microwave transistors. We started with the knowledge of microwave bipolar junction transistor. Bipolar we say because the operation of the device is responsible because of both the charge carriers majority and minority. We have seen its physical structure, the operating principles, the various transistor configurations, amplification phenomena. Then we switch to the heterojunction bipolar junction transistor. So here the junction was with respect to the two different kinds of the semiconductor, hence the name hetero. We have also seen the family of field effect transistors. We started with the JFET junction field effect transistor, and into the recent past videos we have addressed the MESFETs, standing for the metal to semiconductor field effect transistor. Now in this video we are going to address the high electron mobility transistors. These devices are dealing with the microwave energy with the high amount of operating frequency, I can say, because of the higher electron mobilities. So let us see the details. So here we start with our topic, high electron mobility transistor. As the name suggests, the operation of this transistor is dependent on the electron mobility. So electron mobility is responsible for the fast switching application operation of the device, I can say. So therefore, fast switching can be regarding as the feature that is making this particular device very, very popular here. We can see few of the statistics why this high electron mobility transistor, the name is given to this device and it is popular for. Now when we are making a consideration of 10 raised to the power 17 per centimeter cube to be the donor concentration. The donor concentration we usually represent with the help of capital N suffix D. So this is with respect to the free electrons into the semiconductor materials, and when we consider the room temperature, so at that time the electron mobilities or the mobilities of the charge carrier, we can say, are of the order of 4000 to 5000, and these are measured in terms of centimeter square per volt second here. Now instead of having the observation for the room temperature, when we increase it to 70 degree Kelvin, slight change is observed in these values of the electron mobilities. Now when we use undoped type of gallium arsenide, as we work with the semiconductor materials, we know that the most popular are the silicon material and germanium material. Along with these two, we have gallium arsenide, indium phosphide, and so on. Gallium arsenide material is having higher electron affinity with respect to the silicon and the germanium here. Therefore, for the high frequency operations, the preference is given first of all to the gallium arsenide here. So when at the room temperature the undoped type of gallium arsenide is used as the material, so that time the electron mobilities are of the order of, here we have the values, 2 to 3 in multiplication to 10 raised to the power 5 in terms of again centimeter per square per volt second. So see that as compared to the silicon material initially in the assumption at the room temperature, see the electron mobility values, they were initially of 10 raised to power 3, have been increased to 10 raised to power 5. So this results into the fast operation of the device, and we can have the device operated at higher microwave frequencies. Microwave frequencies are of the order of 1 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. In the previous topic, when we have addressed metal to semiconductor field effect transistors, MESFETs, the use of gallium arsenide type of semiconductor material had resulted to work into the X band. So for X band, we have the operating frequencies ranging from 8 to 12 gigahertz. So instead of 8 to 12 gigahertz, now we can work up to 50 to 70 gigahertz when we get the field effect transistor modified to the form that we are going to address now for the high electron mobility transistor, making the use of undoped type of gallium arsenide. Now we shall be addressing a schematic diagram which will help you to have more details with respect to this device. See, in this schematic, we start with the lower portion here. In the lower portion, we represent here the gallium arsenide material that is of semi-insulated type here. So for semi-insulated, I write SI into the abbreviation form here. So on to the semiconductor substrate of gallium arsenide semi-insulated type, there has been the growth of undoped type of gallium arsenide material. And after the undoped type of gallium arsenide material, there is another growth of the N-type. Here we have aluminium gallium arsenide material here. So this is with respect to the undoped type of aluminium gallium arsenide material here. You can see here, this is the layer that we can call the semi-insulating buffer that separates the original substrate of gallium arsenide from the undoped type of the gallium arsenide and further the undoped aluminium gallium arsenide material here. Now here we have another separation with respect to the N-type of aluminium gallium arsenide material from the undoped type here. So this is referred to as TOIS DEG. So TOIS DEG refers to the two-dimensional electron gas here. So that we shall be explaining further here. Now here onto the both sides here. Here we have the source terminal. Usually in the case of field effect transistors, this terminal is responsible for allowing the flow of electrons for the operation of the device. And at the latter end, we have the drain terminal. So the drain terminal is responsible for taking out the flow of electrons from the operative region of the device here. In between the two, we have this one to be the gate. So we have the biasing with respect to the gate and source and gate and drain here. So the gate terminal is responsible for making the reverse biasing and finally controlling the flow of drain current into the channel of the field effect transistor here. So here we have here this material corresponding to the source and the drain here, whereas the gate is shown into this particular schematic diagram here. Now we shall be explaining the various steps involved in fabrication of the high electron mobility transistor. So the total we are going to address around 5 steps here. The very first step here we shall be explaining with the help of this schematic diagram, and this process is called as ohmic contact formation. In ohmic contact formation, the ohmic contact is shown here. The rest of the details into the diagram are the same as just now we have seen one of the schematic for the high electron mobility transistor here. So here we have the gallium arsenide
substrate here of the semi-insulating type here. Now this is the undoped type of gallium arsenide material. Now here we have the electron buffer that has been shown with the help of dash line, we can see here. Now here we have the aluminium gallium arsenide material shown with the shaded portion. Next to that, here we can say this is nothing but the cap layer that has been next to this aluminium gallium arsenide material, and here we have the representation of insulating material. I just mentioned insulator here. So in the cap material, we have the three layers that we can distinguish for the gallium arsenide: aluminium gallium arsenide and further gallium arsenide here. Now next to the process of ohming contact formation, we have the next one represented in this particular schematic diagram, that it is opening the gate windows. So along with the source and the drain terminal, the gate terminal is very, very important for the operation of the field effect transistor. So in this schematic, we have the photoresist material that is responsible for the opening of the gate windows. Rest of the materials into this schematic are the same from the previous step here. Now after the opening of the gate windows, we have the third step. The third step is having the selective type of dry etching into the semiconductor material from the previous step here. So for the dry etching purpose, we have the use of the materials represented here: CCl2F2 or HE, standing for the helium. Here at the base, we have semi-insulating type of the gallium arsenide substrate here. After the selective type of dry etching, we have the metallization or the gate metallization, especially we can say here. In the gate metallization, the gate metal is shown in between these two portions from the previous step. So this is nothing but the gate metal for the contact purpose here. So here we have the same semi-insulating gallium arsenide substrate here. Lastly, we have the fifth step, where we have the interconnect metallization. So in the interconnect metallization, here we have the interconnect metal after the gate metallization process. So this is one more layer we show here. And with this step here, we have the separation of the E type of HEMT and D type of HEMT. So the E type and the D type are corresponding to the enhanced type or the depletion type of the channel with respect to the high electron mobility transistor here. So as the operation of this particular device will be concerned here, the upper layer, that is of the N-type aluminium gallium arsenide material, that will be having the depletion region completely as compared to that of the undoped type of the gallium arsenide below to that, that has been separated by the two-dimensional electron gas that will be of the order of 100 angstroms in the dimensional case here. Now we shall be getting the details of the high electron mobility transistor that has completely been fabricated with the help of another schematic diagram. So in this diagram, we show you the more details with respect to the formed high electron mobility transistor here. So I just have a summary of the processes that we have gone so far. So this is the semi-insulating type of the gallium arsenide material. So next to that, we have the undoped type of gallium arsenide. So that has separation, the separation represented by the electron layer that we have already represented by 2DEG, so two-dimensional electron gas layer here. Next to that, we have the aluminium gallium arsenide material, and next to that again we have gallium arsenide fabricated, above which we have the insulator material that has been represented by the silicon dioxide, and here we have again the insulating material by the SiO2 here. So here we have, as per the first step, the ohmic contact to start the device operation. This is the gate terminal will be responsible for controlling the amount of drained current through this field effect transistor. Here we have the interconnect metal, which is from the last step of fabrication of this HEMT here, and the separation for the regions of E type of HEMT and H type of D type of here HEMT we have represented in this particular schematic diagram here. Now when the source terminal, drain terminal, gate terminal are there for the field effect transistor, and the transistor is operated into the normal mode of operation. So in the normal mode of operation, whatever the N type of the gallium arsenide along with the aluminium material is there, that has the complete depletion. So whatever the free electrons are there in that particular region, they are completely trapped in the depletion region here. Further, the operation of the device is taken place as the similar case we have gone so far for the metal semiconductor field effect transistor and the JFET there. Now we shall see the summary of performance characteristic with respect to this device. So when we talk about the performance characteristics, as our topic belongs to the subject microwave engineering, we shall be focusing more attention with respect to the range of frequency. So the generalized range of frequency may extend for the high electron mobility transistor for 40 to 70 gigahertz. When the typical operation for the 60 gigahertz of operating frequency is taken place, so that time the gain for the amplification purpose, the signal amplification with the help of HEMT, has resulted into the gain value in terms of the decibels of 4.5 to 6.5 decibels here. Now this is the value of the gain. And when we talk about the noise, so for the noise we have the performance metric called as noise figure. For this typical operation with the gain of 4.5 to 6.5 decibels, the noise figure is observed to the value of 6 decibels. So to see the performances of the earlier members from the family of microwave transistor, the performance with respect to the microwave application has been boosted up in the case of high electron mobility transistor here. Now we shall be having a simple formulation with respect to the drain current that has offered into the device operation. So the drain current that has been the outcome of device operation can be mathematically represented with the help of the equation that is representing I suffix ds for the drain current here, obtained by the multiplication of Q into N of Z into capital W into V of Z here. So this is the very important equation that may be helpful to solve the problems if come based on to this device HEMT here. So here we have small q, nothing but the electron charge here. And we know that for the electron charge, the constant value is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 of coulombs here. Whereas the representation of N of Z is nothing but the concentration of two-dimensional electron gas here. So that separates the two layers into the HEMT, the cross-sectional schematic you have seen. Next to that, capital W gives the width of the gate terminal. So I simply mention the gate width. So this is also the responsible factor to have control of the drain current here. Lastly, we have V of Z, nothing but the electron velocity. We generally call the electron velocity to be the drift velocity, which is seen to be finally at the saturation stage here. So this was the drain current that simply we can give it to be the equation number one here. And if you see the drain voltage variation with respect to the variation of the drain current obtained, we call the plot to be the IV characteristics. So let us see the IV characteristics for the high electron mobility transistor. So here in this plot, for the horizontal axis, we represent the drain voltage by simply V suffix ds, and this is in terms of volts here. Whereas onto the vertical axis, we take the measurement of I suffix ds to be the drain current measured in terms of milliamperes here. So for the intersection of the two axes, we take the origin starting at the zero values for both the voltage and the current here. We extend the voltage values with the measurement of 1 volt. Then we have 2 volt. Next to that, we have 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 7 volts we have in this plot. Whereas the markings of 10 milliamperes, 20 milliamperes, 30 milliamperes, 40 milliamperes, and 50 milliamperes we show in this particular plot here. Now we have the representations of the triangle symbol corresponding to the measured values from the experimentations of the scientists those have proposed and worked with the device high electron mobility transistor here. Whereas the solid lines have been plotted here, they have been drawn here to see these measured values. So these are nothing but the predictions made from the experimental results here. Now we have the several lines to be shown for the drain current versus the drain voltage. So these are at the various constant values of the gate potential here. So here the gate potential is with the value 0.6 volt. If we lower it down, this is for 0.4 volt, this is for 0.2 volt. Next to that we have 0 volt, and into the negation when reverse biased we have 0.2 minus 0.2 volts here, minus 0.4 volts, minus 0.6 volts, then minus 0.8 volt is very, very close to that of the zero drain current that we have obtained here. So the diagram is very, very self-explanatory to show you how the device operation for high electron mobility transistor works. So just now we have seen the IV characteristic with respect to the device operation here. Now sometimes the equivalent circuitry for understanding and further analysis of the device operation and the performance analysis, we have the helpful equivalent circuitry. So this is the diagram that you can regard as the equivalent circuit of the device high electron mobility transistor. The various components in terms of the resistances, the inductances and the capacitances along with the source we show in this particular diagram. So here this is the terminal with which we mostly control the device operation. For the output drain current, this is nothing but the gate here. Now we have the another terminal that is giving us the output, that it is the drain terminal, and this one is the source terminal. So these are the very important three terminals responsible for the device operation here. With respect to the branch towards the gate terminal, we have the inductor represented capital L sub G for the gate, and the typical value is 0.15 in terms of nanohenry. Whereas in the series connection, we have a resistance denoted by R sub G. The typical value is 8 ohms here. Similarly, with respect to the drain terminal branch, we have the inductor represented capital L sub D here with the typical value 0.14 nanohenry, whereas the resistance into the series connection is represented R sub D with the typical value 2.2 ohms here. Now for the source terminal, we have the inductor represented capital L sub S with the typical value of 0.03 nanohenry, whereas the series connection of resistance is represented RS with the typical value of 1.2 ohm here. Now inside we have the capacitance between the gate and the drain, we can say represented C suffix GD with the value 0.012 picofarad, whereas the resistance in between the gate and the drain is represented as capital R suffix GD with the typical value 0.001 ohms here. Now when we take the case of gate and the source, we have the capacitance represented C suffix GS, the value is 0.18 picofarads, and the resistance capital R suffix GS is equal to 4.6 ohms here. Now here we have the capacitor that has been across the drain and the source terminal, hence it is represented as C suffix DS here. It has the value 0.08 for the typical case in terms of picofarad, whereas the resistance here, it is R suffix DS, and 281 ohms is the typical value here. Now here we have the current component represented in the product of the transconductance G suffix M into, here we have e to the power minus j omega t, where we have 54 millisiemens, the value 1.8 picosecond along with. So this is a function of time and the transconductance that we have represented for the equivalent circuitry. Now with respect to the details that we have discussed so far for the high electron mobility transistor, one expression is helpful to us to see the vertical threshold sensitivity of the device. So it is expressed in terms of, here we have the differential of VTH with respect to the differential of L. So this is computed in terms of minus the square bracket that has a power 1 by 2. That means it is under square root. That involves twice of Q into ND. In the parenthesis, we have psi suffix ms minus delta of EC minus VTH divided by epsilon. So I provide the power 1 by 2 to represent the square root here. Now, the expression representing the sensitivity of the device here involves the parameters that we express here. So V suffix TH is nothing but the threshold voltage. So threshold voltage, of course, measured in terms of volts. The L represents the very important material portion, that is of aluminium, gallium arsenide layer, and this is nothing but the measurement of thickness of this layer. And as far as the SI system of measurements is concerned, it is in terms of meters here. Next to that, on the RHS, if you see Q is there, that it is nothing but the electron charge with the constant value of 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs there. Next to the electron charge, we have the representation of N suffix D to be the donor concentration. So here the donor concentration, as the material is of N type here, we have the majority charge carriers electrons. So this is simply the electron concentration. Psi suffix ms here represents the metal to semiconductor, the Schottky barrier potential here. So here we have Schottky potential, I write, where the metal to semiconductor, if we take the metal to be the aluminium here, and semiconductor material is of course the gallium arsenide material selected. Now in the formulation, on to the right hand side, we have a mention of delta of capital E suffix C here. So here capital E suffix C refers to the conduction band difference. So conduction band difference is for the regions of semiconductor materials, gallium arsenide and aluminium gallium arsenide here, whereas epsilon is the permittivity of the material here. So the permittivity of the material, epsilon, can be epsilon 0 times epsilon r, where epsilon 0 is permittivity of the free space or the vacuum, epsilon r is the relative permittivity, which is a constant for a specific semiconductor or a metal. We can say practically the metals will have the lowest possible value for. So here epsilon r will be the relative dielectric constant for, I can say here, dielectric constant for aluminium gallium arsenide material. So I hope we can conclude the topic high electron mobility transistor here with the sufficient knowledge that we have shared so far. So by the next lecture, we shall be having a practice of two problems based on this high electron mobility transistors here. I hope you enjoy learning the subject microwave engineering. For the more details of concepts and the knowledge, you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.